We are here in the beautiful Ahuriri, Napier, and I'm sitting here with two ladies who want to make this place even more beautiful. They have a goal, 100% youth employment in the Hawke's Bay region. That is their lofty vision of the company called Lift. In the 2.5 years since Lift has been running, the social enterprise has engaged with around 500 young people, helping them set goals, getting them ready for work, and engaging them with employers. Lift's founder and director, Jody Hamilton, joins us alongside Tyler Haurima-Brown, one of the organisation's success stories. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
It's amazing. And we were just having a conversation about Lift, and it's such a cool organisation. Tell us about the inspiration behind it.
Yeah, absolutely. So I've got an 8-year-old son called Paimako, and I work a lot in the space of community development, social development, economic development, and I was looking at the statistics for the Hawke's Bay region, and I thought, as Paimako's mother, what goes on for our young Māori boys in this region is it's crazy, you know, in terms of their participation in early childhood, what goes on for them at school. They're 3 times more likely to be suspended, and then moving into employment and unemployment. The stats just didn't play out for me, and I thought to myself, well, either I leave this region because I want his future to be a great future, or I'd just be part of changing it. And I love this region, I don't want to leave this region. So it was about, right, what can we put in place to change it?
This region has been in the news lately, and not for great reasons. We've obviously had stories about gang violence. Why is that affecting the Hawke's Bay region, do you think?
I don't think it's much different to what it's always been. Certainly some, you know, we've got some higher numbers and that sort of thing. But our young people have always been looking for connection and pathways. And so in a lot of ways, Lift is just another way of connecting and with our young people and loving them and providing another pathway.
Yeah. So it's a pathway towards meaningful employment.
Yeah.
And Tyler, is that why you came to Lift? Were you searching for a connection?
Yeah, totally, yeah. How I started with Lift actually was I ran away, 2016-17, I ran away after I had finished my last exams, and I had burnt bridges with nearly everybody in my family because of that. and I was looking, I was looking for a way to get away from all of that. I was looking for a way to bring myself back, either going to school, going to work. At the time I was like 15. Mm-hmm. And I had enrolled into so many courses, but because I was only 15, I wasn't old enough, and they had 16 and over, and so they couldn't cater to me. And actually I was down at the market with my whānau, and Jody and her whānau were actually down there advertising Lift, and straight away she was just like, do you know any rangatahi that are looking for employment? I said, me.
Yeah.
That's me, you know. And I was just telling my dad, I said, but I can't do it because I'm not 16 yet. And so she gave me their card and she said, come in the next day, which was Monday. And I went in, and in a space of 3 days, my life had changed.
Wow.
And what we do at Lift is we look at the rangatahi, the person themselves, and individually as well. And they ask us about how we're living life and how we feel. We're like, are you living the life you love?
Mm-hmm.
And at that time, I was, from a 1 to 10, I was living at a 2 in my life. I was not happy. I was ready to just end it. And in 3 days of doing bounce, that had changed. My life had just completely shifted to an 8. And that was 3 days of doing the 2-week course. And a lot of it about bounce is self-awareness. Self-awareness, bringing the unconscious to conscious. And looking at the way we filter things, our model of the world to someone else's model of the world. And things like that, the generalizations we make, how we filter things from external events and stuff like that. And why we do the things we do, why we think the way we think and how our brain works. And I think that is just, it's so powerful. I mean, in 3 days' time from a 2-week course, if I went from living at a 2 to an 8, that speaks for itself.
You as a person sitting here talking to you speaks for itself too. You're a wonderful young lady. And You said you were at a two and you're at a low, but you mentioned that you wanted to bring yourself back. Myself back, you said. Yeah. Is that important? Yeah. Do you think that people want to change?
Absolutely, yeah. So Tyler talked about Bounce, and it's this life skills program that I actually found and was part of in Australia a couple of years ago, and I thought, we don't have anything like that in New Zealand. And it is this incredible journey where our rangatahi get a chance to really look into themselves, and they look to where they want to be, and then we just support them to put those steps in place. It is actually that simple. And that support looks like love, it looks like it's practical. And then we do things like make sure they've got a good connection with a good employer. So it is just practical. It's helping them achieve what they know they want to achieve.
But you're not just an employment organisation.
No. So our kids come to us. I call them my kids, but our rangatahi come into us because they want a job. So it's voluntary. They're our customers, right?
Yes.
They don't have to come to us, but they come to us because they want mahi. But in saying that, a lot of our kids are homeless, and so we've housed probably 30 over the last couple of years. They come and they disclose drug and alcohol issues, so we work with them around supports for that. Same around mental health. They come and they've got a huge number of justice issues, so we're constantly working with them and the police and corrections, courts, probation services. We've had a number of our kids go to prison, so we work with the prison and corrections to, you know, get them out so we can continue to work with them in the community. So yeah, it's certainly not just an employment agency, but the employment is the hook for them to come in.
And it seems like there's no judgment. You're not turning people away because of who they are.
No, that's not lived, no.
Tyler, if somebody wanted to come and get some help, but they were scared or they thought that they weren't the right person or they didn't have it, what do you have to say to them? Why should they come to Lift?
I don't like to use the word why, because why opens up to many different things, and sometimes that can trigger them, and we don't want to do that. It's more about asking, what can we do for you? What is it that you're looking for from us that we can help you with?
Wow.
Yeah.
That is amazing. You guys are so inspirational. And what do you have, what sort of vision do you have for the region? What do you hope to do for the young kids here?
So it was in the intro, it is about 100% youth employment. Yes, it is lofty, but we pride ourselves on working really closely with anyone else who wants to work with us. Mm. And there are some incredible organisations and people in this region. And, you know, working together more closely with them, we can achieve that vision. I know it.
Mm. So. And your kids are good workers?
Our kids are great workers. Well, and Tyler's actually working with us now. She's one of our staff members now. So that's also one of the things we do is we put our money where our mouth is.
Yeah.
And we've had about 6 of our previous customers who have worked with us.
You guys are amazing, honestly, very inspirational to talk to you both. Definitely local heroes. Thank you so much, Jodie Hamilton and Tyler Haurima-Brown.
Thank you.